Hello, Francis McShane here, and in the next few minutes I'm hoping to show you why Windor Plus is such a fantastic extension for doing windows and doors and window door assemblies. We'll get straight in with a window door assembly. I'm not going to explain too much because the explanations are all done in other videos. I'm just going to create a default window door assembly and start editing it here. Just place it now and right click it and edit it. And kind of things you can do when you're editing it are add a window, for instance, change the height of the width, sorry, of the window door assembly, the height of the door, and the height that the windows are going to be at. I'll just OK that, and I will edit window door DB because I want it to be a fixed width, and so I'll set it that I determine its width, so I'll make it 0.9. And just OK that. Don't want to edit the door leaf. I do want to edit the window, so that it has a higher sill. OK that. Make the sill about, I don't know, 1.8 metres. OK. And we'll do it again, nope. And this is now the window asked me the setup for that extra window at window C that I put in, or sorry, window B that I put in. So we'll make it, let's say, about 1.5 metres tall. Type fixed. Don't want to edit it again, no. So there we have our window A and A and B, just where we asked it to be. And you'll notice these windows are a bit narrower because this is we've asked this to be fixed width at 900, but they'll all be fitting in to a width of 2.7 meters. If you wanted to make that a tiny bit wider, for instance, say 3.6 meters, just go in there, 3.6, and they'll sort themselves out like that. Just Control Z. Another little thing you can do is add a transom light to the door. This one's the door, so we add a transom light. So there's that transom light. Don't edit that. And we can actually add a transom that covers all the windows and doors. So I'll show you how that happens. Transom window. This is the information for the transom window. We'll just accept the default. So there you go. Finally, you can do that, which creates this outline of the whole thing. And if we just go into that and delete all of this stuff in the middle and explode it. Oops, pick it again and explode it. I should get an outline, yep, and I can then just push that through 0.3, and that it's just a little help for creating the opening through a two-face wall. And just to show you, if I click into the window and pick out the door, these are just window objects themselves, and they respond to the window commands. One of the actions you can do to a door now is open the door, so we'll just do that. So I'm hoping that will give you an insight into why this extension is really, it's the extension for doing windows and doors and window door assemblies, and that you'll buy it and enjoy using it. Thank you very much for listening to me. Bye bye.